Welcome back to the ASUS ROG Dreamleague for game three between Team Empire and xGame.kz. Currently, it's been a bit of a nightmare for KZ, to be honest. They've kind of looked like a rabbit in the headlights, but they were in the lobby just moments ago, and they were like, the admin was like, are you ready? And Mantis was like, mega ready.
Mega ready.
He's mega ready for this.
That's good. But, I mean, I want to just go back to the last game really quick and mention that their draft, I feel, was actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Like, I couldn't find any glaring issues with it at all. It was basically just play. Mm. So if they can play well and draft as well as did in the last game, I really do think that they'll have a chance. And again, since these are all best of ones, every game matters. So even if you only win one against a team who's probably favored to place top in the group, you're still going to be better off than the other teams.
Yeah. Huge bragging rights.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, good stuff. You know, don't even know me. My name's Mantis, and I won a game.
Also, in that game where he played Naga, he still had almost 10 CS a minute in a game where they had no map control. So again, it's not like they're not individually skilled. I just feel like in the last game, they couldn't really get on the same page with one another. And I feel like maybe they're not that familiar with Omni Knight and the way that he functions, or at least in the way that most people are playing him nowadays, which is just protect the hero.
It's kind of odd that there are a lot of pro gamers out there that actually are not diverse in a wide range of heroes.
Yeah.
It really surprises me. They don't random enough.
PPD always randoms, man. Random 6K plus.
Okay, well, that doesn't prove my point, because PPD is, you know.
I know, he was the only good person, like, he was the first person that came to mind off the top of my head who randoms, like, all the time. But I think it also has to do with the fact that when you play something at a very high level, like a specific set of heroes, then your consistency on the heroes is so good that the other teams actually just have to sometimes ban them against you, which is why we saw things like Gyrocopter banned out. Death Prophet's been banned every game pretty much so far, I think, against Empire today. So,
well, they take out the Void now, at least.
In a sense, when you're specialized at something, it makes the other team react to it, which I think can be a good thing.
Yeah, it's kind of like I think the first time we really saw that effect in Dota 2 was the Alliance, wasn't it? It was like kind of target down Admiral Bulldog's heroes, and it did end up working out for him a bit. Now he plays like five heroes. He's legit.
He actually plays like every offlaner now. He's actually developed into a pretty versatile offlaner, to be honest. But going back to this game, looks like Team Empire are going to get their hands on the Skywrath for the second time today. And for the first time for them, they're going to pick up the Brew.
Yeah, Brew, just mid-game, so scary and annoying. And it's the only way that you really mess up your ultimate is if the rest of your team don't get the initiation that they also want with you. Like that's really it. It's hard to mess up Brewmaster. And you're actually going to see really fast ban and pick phase here as Visage comes out for KZ after the Perk and Ancient Apparition. We're going to have a Nightstalker for Team Empire.
A Nightstalker is a hero that we don't really get a chance to see too often, but I will say that with the double rune system, I think that hero actually becomes innately better, because Nightstalker is one of those heroes where you don't ever want to go back to base.
No. Nope.
You want to get Urn, you want to get Bottle, a Wand, Boots, and just
huge
go.
Huge amount of levels, yeah. And even the mana cost of his Void is pretty low.
Yep.
Like, it really is. And if you're able to spam that in your lane for, like, either last hits early on or, you know, have retained enough mana to be dangerous if something happens, you can put out a huge amount of damage. And, you know, it starts at 80 mana cost and goes up to 110. Not cheating by putting my mouse over the Void there at all.
No one will know. You don't even have to say it.
Well, everyone expects me to know everything, Andy.
Do they?
Yeah.
Oh. I didn't expect you to know everything. I'm just...
Ask me a question.
All right. What's the capital of the moon?
M.
All right, you got me on that one. That was good. Okay, so the one thing for Empire is I'm wondering which of these two heroes is actually going to go mid. Is it going to be safe lane Brew or safe lane Nightstalker? Or off lane Brew, mid Nightstalker, still haven't picked the safe laner. I really don't know if I like off lane Brew, though, just because if you look at the heroes that xGame already have, it's going to be AA Visage. That's a really powerful zoning combo, although you would have to commit both supports. I don't think just the AA would be able to keep the Brewmaster back.
You need the Slow or the Visage to actually zone people properly, like the Grave Chill. It's like if you time that nicely, you can yeah, put out some significant damage. And Brew doesn't really have much to offer in terms of escaping that situation when he's slow. It's like, okay, you can clap, but no one's going to be close enough to hit apart from maybe a melee carry in that situation. So yeah, we'll see where they take it, Empire, but they certainly, yeah, there you go. It's going to be a Nature's Prophet, which we can expect to go off lane. And a Drow Ranger, it's the Aura Strat. They're turned into C9.
Cloud Nine. Whenever I see the Visage, I kind of think that Drow could be a possibility, because just the sheer physical damage output that you have is completely insane. But picking it into Nightstalker Brew, that's kind of scary for me, especially considering the lack of stun that team currently has. I mean, if you look at
XGame, two stuns.
They've banned out Void, they've banned out Sand King, there's no Naga, there's no Batrider, there's no Mag, so all those stuns and disables are pretty much just completely out of the game. The only catch that XGame have at all is Puck.
Yep.
And he's not going to have it until level 6. And they don't have a frontline hero. So I'm a little bit worried that they could actually just get the old run at treatment and then you die.
Well, they have been a rabbit in headlights for the majority of the game. So maybe that's their strategy to get run over.
I don't know. I feel like their damage output is going to be pretty insane, especially when you have Ancient Apparition and you have the Icy Touch. And then you have four ranged heroes.
Icy Touch. That sounds so cool.
Or Chilling Touch.
That's I like Icy Touch more.
Well, Icy Touch just sounds like you're spent too much time with, like, poor circulation. Wow, your hands are actually very cold. That is ridiculous. You should exercise more. Get some blood flow into the hands.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
Yeah. Mirana, last pick here for Team Empire.
I like the Mirana because with the heroes that they have right now, they're mostly independent, right? Like Nightstalker, Prophet, Mirana, even the Brewmaster to a certain extent can do some stuff on their own. So they're gonna really just utilize the entire map as much as they can. And if a stray arrow lands, then it's a free kill most of the time. There's no counter initiation on the team of the X game until that Puck starts getting some levels.
You need another blue hero for KZ.
Yeah, they are team blue right now. They need an offlaner. Unless they plan on putting the Puck in the offlane. But I don't really see why they would do that. I think they need another hero with some catch, too. Even something like a Centaur wouldn't be a terrible idea, just because you want some kind of disengage. Wow, they're going to go Enigma? That is ultra greedy. That is ultra greedy. Although they could be assuming that the Nature's Prophet is going to be in the woods.
Does Enigma get better vision radius because he has headlights in his eyes?
I feel like he should. He should probably submit that to Ice Frog.
I will.
I mean, the new Aghanims could just be like, you get fog lights too, yeah. You know? They just get a little bit brighter. I don't know. I feel like XGame, this strategy that they have right now with the Enigma, I mean, sure, there's the Skyrath Silence. You can get Boulder Toss when the Brewmaster's in his ulti. You can get Silence. You can get Arrow. There's actually quite a bit that can interrupt him from getting that black hole off. And it feels a little bit all-in-ish to me.
Do you have in-game sounds?
I do not.
No, nor do I.
Wait, maybe I do now. Yeah, I do now.
Yeah, I do. All right, so we are going to have Equal playing the Drow Ranger, heading towards the bottom lane. Followed him is Wattafucker on the Visage, Stylecat on the Ancient Apparition. Reeve's going to be playing mid as the Puck, and heading to the off lane is going to be Mantis. We'll see if he's going to just run out ward.
A very old school idea, by the way, the off lane Enigma. That's something that we haven't seen in a very long time. But it makes sense. I mean, clearly you don't want to put the Puck off lane. You want to keep your 1-1-3 lane pretty static. But it does also mean that he's not going to be able to really get that much farm. Normally your Enigma's going to have like mech at like 8 or 9 minutes.
They can get a kill here on equal. Nope, not going to get a kill. It's too far away. Maybe if they had put 1 point in concussive shot, they might have been able to run him down. But yeah, on the team of Empire, it is going to be always want to fly on the Skyrath Mage. Silent is going to be playing the Mirana and solo on the Nightstalker. And all the way in base right now is Resolution, just summoning his second set of Treants.
He only made one tree.
And Yoki is going to be on the Brewmaster, so it looks like they're going. It looks like for a moment they were going to go aggressive tri lane. But Silent always want to fly. They just want to rotate. They want kills. And they're just having a little pep talk from Roshan right now.
It's a good team to rotate against because they don't have any escapes. The only hero that would be able to avoid a potential gank is the Puck. And I mean, a Drow, again, Visage and AA, they deal a pretty good amount of damage, but you're not really going to be able to kill on your own. You really need some levels, and the Puck is going to be part of the tri lane. which is
this game has turned out weird.
It is
Equal
a little bit
rotated
odd.
Out. I mean, the thing about Silent on that Mirana is like, if you hit an arrow on a Drow against the lineup that you've got, it's dead. So Equal actually going mid is, we'll get him a fair exchange in some of the farm. He can actually get harassed a little bit by
bottom lane.
Screw mid lane.
Stealthcat, double damage on Silent. They're going to try to go for a return kill. The first blood does go the way of Empire, but they immediately kill Silent after the fact. And this, this solo Night Stalker, man, this is a support Night Stalker.
He's got boots.
I have to say, I didn't see that one coming.
Not so much.
But I can see the merits of it, honestly, because the mana cost, like you were talking about on Void, is so low, his chase potential is still going to be pretty high as long as he just has a pair of boots.
I don't think you would call him support, though, which is a Night Stalker. He's just on offlane farming.
Well, he's not farming. He's just denying creeps.
I think he'd be farming.
He has no creep kills.
He's just not very good at farming. Oh, and he's solo playing him, okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely a support Night Stalker, but I think in some kind of weird way it actually fits, because they have somebody who can just relentlessly chase against a lineup that has basically no escape mechanism at all. You're just gonna run at them. And you have other heroes that are quite fast, like Skywrath Mage, very high base move speed, Mirana has Leap, you have Prophet who can just teleport into the fights, your Brewmaster's gonna get a blink. I mean, they're gonna go for the kill. Like, you said it pretty literally earlier. You know, they just wanna fight.
They want to, and actually always wanna fly, gonna take a little bit of damage. Solo just going to throw out a Void to push away the Butterfucker, and Reese is going to have to heal up with a salve. And yeah, I'm not really sure. Like, they can't really take fights down here. It feels like the only big damage output they have is Watafaka, who was the carry Rubick of last game, one of the highest levels for his team. But yeah, if he can get some good soul assumptions off, that would be nice. But let's check on the other lanes how they're doing. Up here on the top lane, Mantis got himself 8 last hits, 3 denies, doing A-OK. And in mid, Equal is actually going to be, should be trading fine, and will get easier and easier as his damage goes up. But Resolution, still doing a fantastic job. He's actually 12 last hits and 7 denies.
Bottom lane, they're going on solo. They want to try to get a return here on the Stealthcat. They might be able to do so, and indeed they do. Silent ends up picking
no
that one up.
No, a soul assumption.
Still continues to be a 1-for-1 exchange here. Both teams just killing for other kills, I guess.
Visage is really good in tri-lanes, you'd agree, right?
Yeah, of course. Like he is the king of tri-lanes, yeah. Pretty much. Because Soul Assumption just scales so ridiculously well depending on how much damage is taken in the area. And the ability only has a 4-second cooldown, and it's almost 1400 range. So you're always going to be able to follow up damage so much as you have mana. And the ability mana cost is still quite high, but the damage output is equally as high, so.
And
it's very,
got,
very good.
The Ancient Apparition has 1 point in Chilling Touch, currently level 1, so they've got that to add as well for some damage output. But yeah, this is an interesting lane to follow, and certainly you could see some small mistakes which could throw it in one team's favor in a pretty big way, because mid lane looks, you know, safe for both players, no one's going to have a problem, and also Mantis up against Yoki on their safe lane of Empire is going to be easy as well. So not really going to be much action across there until the supports decide to rotate. And I'm not against, you know, this so far for KZ. I don't think this is turning into a bad game for him by any means.
I think if the lane continues to play out the way it is right now and they just trade KZ's even, I think X Game win the lane, because they have the Drow who is just skilling Aura. And we are going to see a rotation here towards middle lane. Solo is only level 2 right now. He's got the nuke and he should be able to tank the tower for some time. He does have that Orb of Venom. He wants to try to go in here. Trees gonna kill him in place here. Solo taking some damage. He's gonna try to drop tower aggro sooner or later. Yeah, there we go.
He dropped it actually twice there.
Yeah,
between an auto attack as well. So nicely played by Solo.
And bottom lane, they're actually gonna get a kill 2v3 as Silent kills Stalcat. So that had to have been an arrow. Yeah. There's no other way that would have happened. And that's the kind of thing that we talked about. It's like, doesn't matter if there's 3 heroes there. If you get arrowed, you're gonna die.
Stalcat really needs a new style, Andy.
4 out of 10. Four out of 10.
I'm not even trying anymore, okay?
But I'm still giving you the 4, and that's because of our friendship, all right?
We're friends?
Kind of. Top lane. Looks like Mantis is actually going to get a solo kill here on the Brewmaster. That puts him over level 6. Now he's got his Black Hole. And this is another nice thing that X Game actually have going for them is, and a 1v1 Enigma is extremely hard to beat. Because the amount of damage that you have with conversions, you have a stun. And I mean, once you get level 6, you basically have 3 stuns. You can just apply so much pressure on your own bottom line. They want to go for a dive. Reeves, he jumps to the orb straight away solo. Going to eat a solo assumption and just drop. No damage really to kill Reeves, unfortunately. They will get him a little bit after some auto attacks arrow. And the arrow.
Stop the soul assumption coming out on resolution. And I think actually resolution was just around line of sight and was able to avoid it. Yeah, but yeah, the mid tower is now gone as well. Mantis actually ended up dropping to Yoki at top. He stayed a little bit too long and no ulti had to be used either from the brew who chased him down. And this bottom tower could be going down. We'll see if the TP's come in. Resolution is low. Pretty low mana on both Silent and also, of course, always on the fly. So they will actually bring back in Reeves, but unfortunately, he's level 4. Not going to be able to chase so well in this situation, nor his damage output is going to be so huge with just Illusory Orb, actually the only level 2 spell that he has. But the Fakir is going to smoke with Stylecat. They're like, we're going to get here really quickly.
Well, they can definitely get kills. Always on the fly is very low on mana right now. Silent, nope. He's got phase boots, he's got a bottle as well, so he'll be able to sustain. And Solo has actually decided to just go top. He buys a TP, so I'm assuming he's probably going to make his way back down bottom at some point. Here comes Always Gonna Fly. Soul Assumption probably going to be coming out here. There it is, gets the kill. Wanafaka going to eat an arrow in the face, and Solo with a double damage is going to pick up that kill after a few auto attacks.
Silent.
Phase shift up very soon. There's the silence. Solo continuing to chase, has those 7 wand charges, pops him. Doesn't even need to use another
AA down as well now. No boots Stylecat.
No, Stylecat, please. Yeah, there's no getting away from this. And this is kind of what we were talking about.
The last hit. Gets a triple kill.
The support Nightstalker gets a triple kill because nobody on X Game has any mobility.
It's almost like you need your Enigma down there now when the team fights come in, because that's such a powerful stun to have, and the threat of a black hole. And actually on top lane, Mantis is going to use black hole on Yuki, and he'll be going down shortly. A little bit more
split.
Damage. Oh, the split comes in last moment, and he's actually going to turn it around. And resolution comes in as well. Mantis,
hurts.
You tried so hard, and we commend you for it.
I thought you were going to say, and got so far, and then I could have said in the end, it didn't even matter.
Right. Bottom
we're gonna
lane,
see coil.
You're going to have a coil. Silent doesn't have leap, has a phase boots, which he'll be popping now. Actually gets his bottle back as well. He's like, I'm going to be here. Arrows, resolution comes in. Always want to fly is here. We are going to see the Mirana drop. Reeves will be going second as well. And Wetterfucker stood all by his lonesome, trying to exchange with resolution the best he can. But nope, not going to happen with the damage coming in from the supports of Empire will drop. So they get the Mirana. They get nothing else.
Empire's team is almost entirely comprised of early game skirmish heroes. Like, that's what they're good at, is taking these small engagements. They have high mobility, they have very spammable abilities that do a decent amount of damage, and they just will win the fights if they're drawn out every single time. I am kind of confused as to why Silent decided to run into the corner. I think he would have lived if he just kept running towards the tower instead, and they probably still would have been able to chase down those kills. But either way, he ended up getting his team 2 kills, and they're going to get the safe lane tier 1 out of this as Resolution TPs towards the bottom lane.
Yep. Solo taking some harassment. Arrow comes in, and Silent will jump in with a level 3 Star Storm, help get the kill and take out Equal, which is the only member of the team so far in XKZ that's had a somewhat decent game in terms of just farming up. 34 last hits, but certainly wasn't having a bad time in getting focus and dying. Yoki up top under Moonlight will open up onto Reeves. Reeves will try and orb away. He will be able to do so, but Mantis will get locked down, and Solo looking to maybe chase and decides against it. Nope, now he wants to go. Silent's like, look at this arrow, guys. It's totally going to hit. Oh my god, it hits.
You totally jinxed it. You said it wasn't going to hit, and then it just hit him right in the
it's
face.
It's like he cast it
to
under
be fair,
tower.
To be fair, Resolution was TPing anyway and would have killed them if the arrow didn't. Wadafuck again to eat a sprout into a Mystic Flare bottom lane and just explodes from the sheer damage output. And Empire have more or less run away with the early game now. They have an 11 kill advantage at 9.5 minutes into this game. So I think really the lineup that Empire have is just well suited to taking these early game engagements, whereas X Game kind of needed at the very least the Puck and the Enigma to come to the fights. Like, you need Mantis 6, you definitely need Reeves to hit level 6, and that's when you want to start applying pressure, but Empire is just not giving them the room.
I would have been fine having the Drow Ranger on the safe lane in the tri lane, by the way.
I think they put the drow mid specifically for the aura, because if you get the aura maxed out and then you put 1 point basically into marksmanship, your tri-lane damage starts to become a little bit ridiculous. And taking the straight-up engagements in the early part, I think, was more advantageous for Empire, because if you draw out the laning phase, a triple range lane with superior harass is going to win every single time. But if you take the engagement and just trade one for one, and you're only losing a support hero, or maybe you lose Silent once, but you end up getting First Blood, that's a trade the Empire is more than willing to make. And yeah, Reeves is not living through that. Not even close.
From the Wrath of Nature comes in on top of the Ancient Seal. It's going to do a little bit too much. Only level 2 Ancient Seal, but still 35% solo. But you're going to get turned on by Mantis and Wattafucker here. Pretty slow in the current state, but he will have some support in the shape of the Brew, and now also Resolution comes in, and they aren't getting the kill onto solo. Nope, they will do with the last hit from Mantis, but they will pick up one for themselves as they take down the Visage. And Empire looking to chase, actually Yoki links up to the high ground, but Mantis is already TP'd out, but Equal finds himself in a not-so-great situation. Could TP? Now, G's going to throw out a silence, and that should be enough to get him out. And nicely played to survive in that situation. But across the bottom, Silent just farming away. Phase boots. Got his braces. Throws him on the ground.
Yeah, he's bottling up, man. Standard.
He was Ring of Aquila. Middle, Yoki going to initiate onto Reeves. He will orb away and should be able to get out of here. But still, it's very obvious that Empire should have controlling the pace of this game now.
Again, I think a lot of it has to do with the trades that they were making in the bottom lane. I don't really think you're well served giving kills away to a team that is always going to be superior in fighting, at least until you have your ulties. And Equal is going to get initiated on here once again, middle lane. Blink, clap comes out. There's the Void, and one more crit from Yoki. Gets the kill, and now he's got 1200 gold, so if he wants to go straight Aghs, he can just pick up his point booster. If he wants to go for the aura build, he can do that too, but either way, Empire with a clear advantage. I would actually say that xGame could still win some fights, but it's going to be very difficult. Their coordination is going to have to be on point, and this Enigma...
I don't think you can win a fight where the Primal Split is used. I think it's impossible to actually just survive through a Primal Split in terms of where you are in the game, because even if you get a kill on solo, it doesn't really matter. And he's probably the only one that's going to tank up a lot of damage. I mean, there's a persona who's just like running past the tier two. They're going to kill him and then just back off. And if they want to, this TP needs to be cancelled as an arrow comes in and does cancel it. And I think that was the Enigma looking to TP there. But it's like you get a kill, they can take the tower. They don't need to go any further if they don't want to. And I'm surprised that XKZ picked this as the time to go. Silent actually will be dropping. And in comes the Brute. He's got the Primal Split. And it's going to clear up Wattafucker. It's going to cyclone up the Drow for now. And surely he'll be bringing him down. Solo's there with just enough for one Void. But actually, it's a black hole that gets instantly silenced by Always Want to Fly. And Mantis looking to almost drop to an Urn Charge. And the Drow still running on the left-hand side of the map will go down to Resolution. Mantis almost looking to survive. Yoki blinks into him. And here have a little bit more of Stylecat, which I think has died twice in the engagement here. And Reeves just going to have to back away. So they get silent.
But at what cost?
A lot.
Wow, the double miss on that familiar. That was pretty funny.
Yeah. I just don't think you can win a fight where Primal Split's used anymore, even with Black Hole. So, yeah, I mean, enforcing that engagement was kind of good because they saw that silent, you know, didn't have a good amount of mana and actually could be held in position. And, you know, so it started off pretty okay, but it turned so quickly with the Brew. And even Resolutions, the right click is insane. It's just, he's got his Mjolnir, he's got Blink, he's,
well, yeah, he's
his
got
positioning
Maelstrom.
Is everything he needs.
Yeah.
Maelstrom, sorry.
This is a really telling story of xGame just wanting to play aggressive because they have a very high damage output, but they just don't have the right lockdown to get kills. And when you give Empire an advantage with these types of heroes, they can just take fights on their own terms whenever they want. They don't really have huge ulties they have to wait for, as we just see Reeves explode to a clap and an Nature's Prophet ulti to sprout right into the arrow. Mantis going to be dropping as well. Solo steals a kill with the Void. And now they want to just dive Wattafucker inside of the base. I mean, it's 15 minutes in, and I really don't feel like xGame can do a whole heck of a lot at this point.
What are you talking about, Andy?
I'm just saying. I mean,
the Enigma's just
they're not pausing, so I don't know if that means it's game over.
I like, if you're We need to put a disclaimer. XKZ, don't watch our commentary of this game because it will make you feel bad. But I'm sure you're all lovely people and awesome. But yeah, you're definitely not up to Empire standards. But just to give you an idea of how good Empire are, they don't necessarily, they come in with a game plan and they will take advantage of every single mistake you make. And that's how they've won these games. Like they have been like a team that's like on, oh, we need to change something or do this. They've literally just turned up and they've gone, mistake here, boom, kill. Mistake here, boom. And almost every single time that KZ have made a small error in judgment of like, you know, positioning or whatever, Empire have taken advantage of it. You know, you had Silent on his gyro being able to chase down the Centaur many times. You know, this game, resolution on that Nature's Prophet, 10-0-10.
He had 740 GPM.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Like, he was, like, really, really good. And it's like Mantis as well on his Enigma. He's like, okay, I'm, you know, I got his, he got the kill, and then he was putting on some pressure, and then Yoki comes back in on the Brew, and he's like, actually, I can get a counter kill. And he just gets it. So it's like Empire see these moments of opportunity where they're able to make something happen, and they take it, and they very confidently do so. KZ seem hesitant to play good, aggressive laning phases, just because I don't feel like, you know, you're that confident versus Empire. Because even that tri-lane, I just felt like, okay, solo on a support Nightstalker tri-lane, I think you could punish that quite a lot in terms of right clicks.
No, I think so too. Like, it was a war of attrition lane. You know, you just continually harass. Yeah. You just
and
harass,
that's what you needed
harass,
to do. And they just didn't do it.
If you keep them at a low threshold of HP, especially against that one melee support, they'll never actually be able to engage. Even if Resolution were to TP, for example, if either the middle lane or the top lane Mantis, like playing the Enigma, had a TP, you could TP in and get your own counter kills, because that was the only hero on your team that had a stun up until Puck hits level 6. So, I don't know. I feel like the Drow middle lane also was kind of a mistake, because Prophet...
I was happy with the Drow in the safe lane. I really was, because I think in the War of Nutrition, like, when you have a Puck there, you kind of rely on high, like, you have quite a bit of damage from Puck, you know, on just right clicks with the Drow aura, but I think you rely a lot on at least getting, like, a couple levels in your orb and also your silence to be able to be like, oh, that's a good amount of damage. Now we got a nice follow-up. I think if you just put the Drow in there, just being able to throw a couple of right clicks on solo or make sure you get those last hits, like, even if they hit an arrow on you, I don't think it was that bad, because Wadafaka on the Visage should have been able to turn those fights. It's like, sure, you've got an arrow, but, you know, we've got Chilling Touch and...
Yeah, the damage output was insane.
Was more. And so you had to rely on Resolution, leaving mid lane on his Nature's Prophet to help. And I think Puck in the middle had much more chance of rotation to control the runes with the orb, you know, against
him. Yeah, of course.
And... so I didn't like the way they changed that, and I think that they just need to be more angry, KZ.
I mean,
you need more angry Dota. You
in the first
to be,
two
like,
games,
punch them.
I think their mentality kind of changed, because in the first two games they had a lack of aggression, and then in the third game they were almost over aggressive in a certain way. Because I still feel like trading against Empire with the heroes that they had wasn't really an ideal situation for them. Your 1v1 mid is losing pretty badly, and top, okay, you could say maybe it was slightly even, maybe even more advantageous towards Mantis because it was a Brew versus an Enigma, but those heroes, Mantis never really came to fights. Like, he didn't have a single assist. All the kills that he got were solo kills. Like, when he killed Yoki the one time, but you have to have the Puck in a situation where not just him getting more farm, but him getting the EXP, like you mentioned. He needs to get level 6. But unfortunately, that means that we are going to see our second sweep in a row, 2 days back to back.
Yeah, Empire do it. 3-0. So they're going to be 6-0 on the scoreboard now. So, we're kind of done with our games here. They were riveting. Very exciting Dota today, and I think you guys will all agree. Probably, you'll remember where you are. You know, it's one of those moments, you remember where you were when it happened. You know, it's like, I remember where I was when this game happened. It was big. So, we're done here. So what we're actually gonna do on this stream is we're gonna tune in to Lumi and Bruno's stream to catch their final game between Virtus Pro and Virtus Pro Polar. I don't know what the score line is in terms of who's won how many games, but I know VP Polar won the first one.
Yeah, I don't know who won the second.
Yeah. Well, we'll find out, because Polar won both.
Okay.
So we're going to see if they can ace as well. So we're going to go there now. Goodbye, lovely people. We'll see you tomorrow. But for now, we'll see you later. We're not allowed to go. We're chained to the chairs. Send help.
You get farm on your phases, boy. And your offensive triangle will get kills. And the Magnus will farm no matter what.
What's your core here that also could wombo combo? Like, this is already the sickest wombo combo lineup.
You're assuming that the silencer is not a core.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you want a core that is I mean, I guess you could go OD.
Kunkka. Kunkka's pretty wombo. Kunkka goes so well with Magnus and Power as well.
Yeah.
10 seconds to go. Yes. Radiant's pick.
Yeah, welcome to stream A.
See, it was a farming silencer.
All right, farming silencer.
Hello, stream A. You're watching now the draft between VP and VP Polar.
And VP Polar is outpicking the bejesus out of
destroying VP. With the picks. It's destroying. Look at that. They have so much synergy with the Phaser's Void Magnus silencer, the Witch Doctor there for the stance, for the Chronosphere, and the Lion as the last support, which, together with the Witch Doctor, they make a very, very scary roaming lineup. That Terrorblade will never find farm. Skyrath Mage and Dazzle. If they get silenced, they cannot do anything. Same with the pack. And I have no idea what VP is going to pick as their mid hero or offlaner if they decide to put pack. But I don't think it matters. I guess the best choice is the Tidehunter right now.
Do you give yourself more team fight? Not bad. Profit. Okay, or to avoid the fights. Yeah, to avoid the fights. Now, we talked about a lot what Polar could do with the draft. Let's just imagine that they lose a lane completely.
Right.
Then everything we said goes out of window, right? If Puck gets a 10-minute blink, Terrorblade gets a free farm.
Puck versus Magnus. Magnus is going to find farm.
Yeah, both of them is going to find farm.
Yeah, but the only way you lose the lane, the only way you win the lane versus Magnus is if you stop Magnus from farming.
Yeah, Magnus is quite gankable this game. Because normally you have the skewer to fall back upon, but Yol's going to be coming in with Ancient Seal. So in theory, they can actually gank him, especially if you want to pull Sadoi to teleport to the mid lane. So I wouldn't say, hey, you know, VP Polar's got the massively superior draft, the game 100% goes to them. There's still a game left to be played.
Okay, but here's my question to
everybody
me.
Gets sick.
If you decide to gank Magnus, aren't you committing too many efforts to
be a
hero? And then you're leaving exposed your Terrorblade and even opening the lane for the Faceless Void or the Illidan in the silencer to farm.
Yeah, Illidan, carry silencer. Let's see what build he's going to go for.
I love these.
Yeah, we'll introduce it. Illidan playing the silencer. We have Little playing the Witch Doctor.
Is it the Roshan level 1?
Oh, we didn't even talk. Is this even possible?
I guess it is. It is. Of course it is.
Just the damage output.
You have damage output.
Is it going to get scouted? I mean, everything goes out the window if it's a level 1 Roche, a successful one at that, right?
Yeah.
Holy bejesus.
They're not scouting it.
VP Classic. You don't see into the pit. They have no clue, but these heroes, they can't back out, right? They're just in the pit, and they're just tanking it out. All right, BZZ's gonna tank it. He's got 12 armor.
They don't know.
These trees are just hanging out, guys. They're like, yo, let's watch the Roshan happening. They will know if BZZ dies to Roshan. They're getting bashed. I'm not sure if they actually can do it now, but losing damage. Oh, no. Sator's gonna come and tank. Oh, Yo's, his butt is almost out of the pit. Holy shit.
No. I mean, this is...
Sadoi?
Don't get bashed.
Okay, G is next. They're getting clapped as well. Holy crap, they're gonna get it, but very expensive for Roshan. All right, everybody gets it.
Uh-oh.
They're gonna get the first blood as well. Sentry's gonna get dropped down. The orb's gonna come out here, and Little's gonna give up the first blood as well. All right, that's the biggest lead you could actually start the game with. Immediate Roche, immediate first blood, and guess what? Somebody's gonna get a bounty rune. All right, there's no bounty rune up top.
You know what's hilarious?
Teamfight recap?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, whatever.
The thing is that even at this early into the game, because of the comeback mechanic, if for some reason VP Polar now gets one kill...
Yeah, they're gonna be right back.
They're back up.
Okay.
They're essentially back up, which I'm not gonna say that's gonna happen, but... it was actually a good move, even though there was a screw-up from Zidoi. And now it's a game where everyone starts at level 2.
Let's just say the comeback mechanic would have already applied regardless of that kill. So I wouldn't say feeding first blood is a good move. DK Phobos, he's stuck. Did he just jump in the trees?
Yes.
Is this so next level?
I like that. And now suddenly random person decides to eat a tango. I'll be like, whoops.
They would know, right? Like, cause what you would do is you try to find him and then you have that window open, the level up window.
Yeah.
You're like, he's level 2.
They know he's there. And they have to know he's there because
when you say they know he's there, as in they know he's exactly there,
no,
in the area.
They know he has to be in the lane because there's no other way you can put a phaser for him.
Yeah.
I mean, he's not gonna be in the jungle.
This is so next level. This is like my next pup thing.
Next pup thing?
Yeah.
I don't know. I like to farm in my pups rather than stay hidden. You wanna play the coward move?
Yo, look, he's.
Be my guest. It's like it's. Oh, well, that was very entertaining, Scruff.
See you in the spring.
Yeah. He's got Aegis. Doesn't matter. First blood solo kill. Now we were saying what you know, solo hero, selfish hero, whatever. What comes down to is that G is still godly in the lane.
Yeah.
And yeah, he's showing it. It helps the fact that he has the level advantage against Scandal.
Uh huh.
So he's doing a very nice job.
That is fine. Now there's a haste room for the Witch Doctor. Is he gonna try and make something happen with that? He decides that he cannot go and kill the pack.
Yeah.
He's just not a target. And bottom lane, there's no one. Because Cito smartly said, I'm not gonna stay in that lane. I'm gonna give the free farm to the silencer.
No, now he's gonna come back to get a little bit of experience.
Okay, yeah, but now it's just because of this way being so close. And yeah. He gets immediately last warded.
All right, so before everybody tries this void thing, because they seem cool for like a second, here's everything that's bad about it. First of all, you're not putting any pressure, so BZZ is getting complete free farm.
Yep.
Second of all, the two supports get to pull and stack pull and chain pull, so they're getting free farm essentially in the jungle as well. And they could just go off and gank mid, and there's nothing you can do about it as well. He is getting level, and I guess a void
just... Oh, they know!
He's TPing out anyway to cancel that TP?
Nope.
He should have just TP'd to tier 1.
Yeah, he went home.
He panicked TP.
I don't know what he is trying to accomplish with this.
Well, he's getting some heal.
Yeah, that's fine, but it's a tango, right?
Yeah.
That's all it is. And now, actually, that was a really unfortunate timing because he's going to miss all the experience from
Radiant's
this wave.
Top towers.
Which, to be fair, would have been sewn out anyway.
Radiant structures must have been fortified.
But this is a huge push coming from the Terrorblade. This Terrorblade, not only they're getting Erosion at level Radiant's 1, not only they're getting the First Blood, they're also probably getting this top tier 1 tower.
Yeah. And if they continue to kind of snowball and get all the tier 1s, maybe they could get the next Roshan as well.
Yeah.
So we're not really too far off from that point. Back in the mid lane here, Scandal as well as G chasing. Oh, here comes the skewer forward. G, he mistimed it. He's going to try to bottle, and in fact, Radiant's he will get the bottle off.
Now he can go on defensive.
Well,
he's not
if he
level
hits
6
his
yet.
Orb. No, he doesn't.
Radiant
yeah.
got one last top tower.
That is fine. And now they got the tier 1 tower top.
They're not stopping.
No.
What is the Void going to do?
No.
Unfortunately, Magnus is very far
away. Oh, he got the last hit.
Scandal coming in. Scandal is dead. TPing from Sejoy. He had to take that rune, but that's fine. Scandal, or sorry, Sejoy and G continue to dominate this game.
What I don't understand is what the hell are the witch
they want Yo as well on top lane. Silence gonna come in. DK Phobos dead. I think the silence gonna end. He tried to jump.
Radiant's top towers.
Not gonna get the jump off.
This is terrible.
It is
Virtus Pro Polar with a great draft, with the possibility of doing really decent lanes if they had gone aggressive, just misjudging everything, and even having an empty lane in the bottom lane, we haven't seen Lion and Witch Doctor moving at all.
Radiant's tough.
And they haven't been farming the jungle either, because that Lion is, well, is level 4 now, is level 3, and Witch Doctor is just level 2.
Yeah, I mean, normally you say, hey, Lion, you could, in theory, get a gank off in against Puck, but Puck had that Aegis for a long time,
yeah.
Until Puck got a solo kill against Magnus. And at that point, you know, Puck is so far ahead, maybe even ganking him will be difficult. And unfortunately, you know, Lion as well as Witch Doctor, you want to hit your level 6s, so they're primarily focusing on the pull. And let's not forget about Sadoi. Sadoi spent the first couple of minutes sending Treants in the enemy jungle, just harassing the two supports.
Yeah.
So ganking mid was difficult as well. So I think, yeah, Virtus Pro Classic just did everything right, and Polar is just getting wrecked. Yep. I think Yolo will die here.
Yolo will die, but yeah, he will.
Maybe. Really? There's a Global Silence spent for it. G's coming in. He knows the Global Silence is ending very soon, and he's going to go for Winning Rift, Coil.
Oh, the plays!
Wow, that was...
That's Kando.
Oh my god, that was so embarrassing.
Oh, nice save.
I mean, sure.
A win's a win.
I think if people are playing in the land center, that's when you just pause and you stand up and you just look at the other person.
Yeah.
And the other person would just get embarrassed. Wow, that was such an outplayed.
That was so good. And again, G just being who he is, right? And is he 5-0 yet? No, he's 3-0.
He's on his way to 5-0.
He's on his way to 5-0.
I don't remember the last time I've seen such an outplay.
Well, come on, this is not like the first time it happened in the history of Dota either.
Right, but it, yeah, okay, it's...
First time.
Andy says he's the first time.
For the first time forever, I've seen outplay that
card. Oh, Illidan? Is he gonna die? He's gonna die.
Yeah.
Nicely done. I mean, Virtus Pro is a Virtus Pro classic. I mean, despite being down two games in this three best of one, they're showing that they could run away with the game.
Yep.
And they are. Roshan is spawning soonish as
soonish,
well.
Yeah. Oh, a little bit over 1 minute plus the 3 minutes of randomness. Now, here's the thing, right? Like, even if your plan is okay, the silencer was not dying until now, and even if he died, he was getting a lot of farm. The silencer went high enough Midas. Now what? Do we wait until level 6 and then we start trying to make the plays? I don't say it's a bad plan.
Yeah. I think you basically just give up any kind of resemblance of map control. But yeah, once you get the blink, is when you start fighting on Magnus. Now.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just look for a skewer, you look for an RP kill. You know, you use your global to back you up and...
Oh, jumping on the gate follows? No, he jumps away.
But all the meanwhile, until you get that blink dagger, the map is VPs, classics. Yep. And you can see that Illidan, or BZZ, is just taking every tower he can. And wow, G is just going for the solo kill.
He has the haze, but is it going to be enough? No, against Kandar. He can take the Witch Doctor, but the Witch Doctor is now playing carefully.
Radiance mid tower.
They're going to apply pressure to this mid tier 1 tower as well, which is something that they can take. Yol and Sido are just waiting in that bottom lane right now. And again, Silencer is the one getting some farm. He's still level 7. Compared to, actually, Illidan is level 7, BZZ is level 7 as well.
So they may get a dive here. Global's gonna get cast. I guess he was just afraid that he's gonna get gone upon.
Oh, Sidoy gets jumped on. There's no level 6. But Sidoy could die here.
Oh, the Wrath is gonna hit on Illidan. I'm not sure why Illidan chased out forward to that fight. Global's almost down as well. Lion's gonna come back in. They really wanted that, but the Mystic Flare, Iron Cannon from the skies. Two more kills being thrown away. They're not playing careful enough.
This is the difference, because Illidan was level 7, just like BZZ.
Yeah. The coil from G on the mid lane with a double damage. He can actually turn around, maybe? No, he needs to orbit himself. No chrono mana. G with treads. He's just running faster. He's going to get himself out of there. All right.
All right. Is he 5-0 yet? 4-0.
4-0. But, like, he dove two heroes between tower. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Illidan is just hitting a base at this moment.
It is a pretty sad situation for the follower.
I like how we started this game by saying that, you know, VP Classic just got completely outdrafted.
But they were. It was just laning.
Oh, it was the Roshan,
or
right?
The Roshan. Yeah, the Roshan was good.
Yeah, and the first blood.
Radiant's bottom tower.
That's just the thing.
Yeah, now Sidoy's forming the enemy jungle. I really have no clue what Polar could do to make the comeback.
It just feels weird because they had a lineup to gank, they had a lineup to get the advantage on kills, they had the lineup that shouldn't die.
Level 1 Roche, man.
Level 1 Roche changes everything. And even though that level 1 Roche almost gets VP killed.
Yeah. it was pretty funny how that one was, because the bashes were coming out, the tree spawn, it was clowny as hell. But I'm sure a lot of pro players out there were just like groaning when they saw this level 1 Roche.
Yeah. Great play, and the right kind of play that you have to do. Oh, Coil. Illidan, he's dead.
Yep. Yeah, he's now 5 in a row.
5 in a row.
There you go.
Andy, like the 3 games, 5-0, 4, G.
Yeah. Radiant's mid tower is getting what for?
Well, okay, G has done everything that an excellent support or excellent mid player should do, which is get really ahead. Radiant. The question is, does he now play with his team? The thing is, he doesn't even need to play with his team, right?
No, no, no.
Mid tower's getting banged up.
I mean, maybe that's a problem, because he's always dominating so hard that he doesn't need to play with his team.
The only thing VP has to do is not overextend.
Yeah.
If they just... I'm not saying they have to not make any mistakes. They just... They have to make any big mistakes.
Yeah.
Like throwing 5 people into Illidan, one by one, and getting killed, and giving him a rampage.
I actually think your highest damage output right now on VP...
Is it Witch Doctor?
It's your Witch Doctor and your Lion. You focus on them getting level 6. Lion has hit that level 6. You can see that Witch Doctor is getting solo farm top.
Oh,
oh no, Scandal. Oh, he's gonna make it out of there.
Yeah.
Yeah, Scandal should just not show his face to G until he gets his blink.
How far along is he?
He's not. He's got 900.
Yeah, he's.
And he has to skip his Arcane for that too. Jeez. Gank happening on the mid lane.
Mm-hmm.
Here comes a Hex.
He comes, it's done.
Yeah. They should be able to get the kill. Finger. Yeah. Big pickoff.
Yeah.
Another blocks? Is he gonna block?
Oh, here comes Yo. TP out.
Just TP away.
Then cuts of shots gonna fire.
Now there's a slow. There is no other poison though.
Oh, he's just walking off. He had 10 magic wand charges. He's fine. Magic wand.
Yeah. And the Witch Doctor for the restoration there. Yeah. Just to save the day.
Great. I don't know why Team 5 Recap didn't
show up. Scandal. Trying to RP but getting silenced just at the last second. He's gonna try to RP again. No, he fails with his killer.
Even if he got the RP up, I'm not sure if he got the kill. Yeah, Scandal's dead.
No, he means it. Okay.
Okay, just kidding. Raph's gonna come down. Oh, the TP in with the Blade Mail! He gets the kill with the Blade Mail! Sedoy, he got Sprout! The long target Sprout! Two more right clicks, one more, got the kill. Global's gonna get used, but, you know, Sedoy traded his life for two, that's fine. Actually, they might trade for three. Earl's gonna come out, Yo's gonna get a kill. DK Phobos, he needs a bash to get this kill. Can he get the bash off? Meanwhile, the fight is... I'm not sure if this is an overextending or just flexing the muscle, but either way, VP Polar is getting dominated.
DK Phobos has no mana, so he has to awkwardly run top.
He's gonna get, yeah, closed off from the back line here.
G comes right now, and he's gonna wrap this up, the silence, the kill.
I like the chaos attempt by G.
Yeah,
saved this orb, but he got backtracked. So karma, I guess.
Four radio people dead for VP Polar. Right
now. This might be like a early 15 minute GG.
Yeah, and kind of to offset the other two matches, it went quite a bit long.
Yeah.
Feel like there's no answer. The Chronos Fear was used.
And now they go back to Roshan.
The reverse polarity was used on a Blade Mail target.
Yep.
They're gonna get Roshan. They have no tier 2 towers. VP Classic has all of their tier 1 towers. What do?
A 5-man smoke into that Roshan pit. Drop the RP, drop the Chrono. Oh, they don't have it. Just kidding.
No. They have none of those.
Yeah, I mean, it's just with that defending high ground.
They have Death Ward.
Yeah, and they have the comeback mechanic, right?
They have their comeback mechanic going for them. But as I said before, the comeback mechanic, the further away you go, the harder it is to come back, actually. So even if they get a couple kills now, it's not going to be the same difference.
Well, you start with a couple of kills. Here we go. It's going to be jump forward. Yo, wow, first hit bash. That's a way to start. And there you go. And there is a kill.
Okay. See, let's see now how much.
It's still a decent chunk.
Yeah.
Show team fight. It's like 1,000 for killing a support. That's not bad.
That's not bad at all.
That's 13 minutes in. You just gain like a staff of wizardry or whatever for like killing a support. And speaking of staff of wizardry, Faceless Voice got a staff of wizardry. I don't know what the hell he's building that into.
What? And then you know? It's an axe.
Then why don't you start with Point Booster?
Because you need the mana. Didn't you see that he didn't have mana?
But
to...
Point Booster gives you mana. Invisibility. Oh, this next level DK Phobos. DD Invis, man. He's looking for some blood.
He's gonna find someone? He finds Yotun.
That's a free kill, right?
Oh, a little bit closer.
No, he's not gonna get the kill. You're supposed to hit and then Chrono. A global? Okay. Okay. All right, now he's dead.
Now he's dead, yeah.
Maybe.
He's outside. Oh, not
he's fine. He's fine. He's backtracking like a pro. All right, I'm looking for the team fight recap. Just kidding. Sedoy's coming in. Sedoy needs to get out of there. Gold Black.
That was an awkward skewer.
I think he wanted to break the trees.
Yeah, the tree, yeah.
Yeah, and Gold Black's dead. Is everybody still dead? DK Phobos running on the right side. Yo, Illidan wants to fight this, but Illidan, I'm not sure whether he got the memo. There's no fighting involved.
And now you push.
Yeah. The high ground is.
Fight recap. Radiant
Midtown. They still probably gain gold.
No, they lost a little.
Okay, they lost a little bit. All right, meanwhile, BZZ has got himself Radiant a little bit of help from his ally.
Yeah, and now you can't do much to stop this push. You don't have RP, you don't have... Well, you have mana for RP.
Yeah. He doesn't have Blink, though.
Chrono.
He still doesn't have Blink. He's really getting hard. Meanwhile, Manta Style's finish on Illidan.
Because why not?
Like BZZ, sorry. I keep getting it too confused.
Yeah. At least Mana Drain destroys Coral Rain's illusions.
And so does Hex, so keep firing them spells at them illusions. Range Rax is gonna go down as well. There's just no defense. They need the Blink RP. Scandal is just getting wrecked. Oh, Sedoy though, he's gonna pop his Blade Mail. Grave's gonna come out here. Gold Black is gonna get picked off by G. And Sedoy still lives. Oh, maybe not. The curse of silence. Yes.
Kills him, yeah.
All right, that's a big kill. Team Fight Recap, maybe when it comes out.
No. Definitely not. BZZ trying to get... He also gets cursed. He also has no mana. But he gets healed because he has Dazzle.
And maybe this will be enough time for Magnus to find his Blink.
Is it though?
Dude, okay. Blink, Death Ward, 3-man Impale into a finger, I believe.
Scruff is getting crazy. You know what I would like to see? Valve, if you're listening to me, I would like to see a net worth differential like the F6 and F7 buttons, but that shows me instead of difference in gold, difference in percentage.
Percentage?
Percentage, yeah.
Yeah, come on. You could do the mental math.
No, you can't.
I mean, really, you could do the mental math. I'm actually not a big fan of like the whole net, the gold graph.
I mean, the gold graph, it's again, 5,000 gold means something different 5 minutes into the game and 25 minutes into the game. But a 20% gold difference.
Yeah.
I understand the same across all the...
I understand where you're getting at. But, like...
Yeah, I think if I was got a bounty rune, this is the beginning of the comeback.
What if bounty rune had like a comeback mechanic? Like the further back you are,
it gives you more gold.
The more bounty. Because if you think about it, if you're really far behind, it's actually really hard to get to that bounty rune.
Yeah.
You have to like go out of the base. They're spending everything just on gold black. Really?
He's
still alive. The chrono, the overextension. G's gonna die and G's gonna give him a 7-kill streak. The comeback is real. Here comes the RP. It got the real one.
Yeah.
The Death Ward's gonna come out. Death Ward's not hitting anything. Now it's hitting on Sedoid. They need a little bit more. Everybody's running with such low health. They will survive. Yeah. And survive they go. Unfortunately, the Magnus will die.
Three down. Radiant's mid-rex has taken a licking. Radiant's mid-rex didn't make it.
Everybody's winner.
It's like an Oprah show.
Yeah, it is an Oprah show. Thank you, Val.
And that is going to be a second lane of racks. And when you get second lane of racks at 18 minutes into the game, your chances of losing the game are pretty, pretty low. Especially when no one from the other team has an ultimate. And it's a team base around fighting around ultimate.
It's done.
So yeah. Anyways. VP Polar. Gonna go 2-1.
Never say never, man. I still believe.
VP Polar. It's gonna go 2-1 today.
Yeah.
And Empire went 3-0.
Yeah. I don't think there's any surprise that Empire is gonna go there, seeing how dominant they were.
Yeah. Which actually means that Empire has secured first place.
Okay.
Because everyone will be. VP Polar will have 5 points. VP will have 4.
Yep.
xGame.kz will have 0. Exactly.
Scandal still alive, still alive, and G's.
G feeding.
This is G, like to the point, right? You get 7 kills and you're like, hey guys, I'm here. And this is just not the patch for that. But Yo is gonna be in a little bit of trouble. The cast, the death ward. Now the grave's gonna come through. He's probably gonna just die to the curse afterwards. Yeah, there you go. Team fight recap, man. They probably earned like 2,000 gold from those 2 kills. Not more. Look at that. 3,000 gold differential! Holy Jesus cow!
But here, 2 Raxes down.
Dude, you know what? 2 Raxes down means more creeps to farm in your base.
But they give less gold.
So? Better than no gold. You know, Mega Creeps should also have a comeback mechanic.
Didn't make it.
Let's just go full Volvo YOLO.
Regeneration. But that's a 5k swing. When you're 22, when you go to 15. But no, I was gonna say, Empire actually hasn't secured first place, nothing. They haven't even secured going through the next stage. There are 6 points, there's one team with 5, one team with 4, and one team with 0. But this is an xGame.kz sound.
Yeah.
Now it's going to be interesting to see tomorrow Virtus Pro Classic going to against Empire. To see if this actually can hold.
Nope, RP. Got some illusions. No, it got the real one. That's Sedoy. Sedoy, gotta get him dead before he popped the blame mail. Yes, he will be dead, but BZZ on the back line. He is just doing so much damage. Illidan's gotta run. And that's a last Rax, man. That's a last Rax line. He gets blown up. Lift's gonna be used. They even have Necro 3. Use Necro 3. Buyback coming out from Sedoy. He wants everybody dead. He gets a Witch Doctor, and I think that's it.
The survivor from the Witch Doctor. He actually has his ultimate, yeah?
Radiant's mid.
He needs somebody to stun people with, though.
Radiant's top rack. The Dire's got a case.
Really done, though.
It was some well fought stuff, but wasn't enough.
Level 1 Roshan. Interesting.
The destroyer of games, man. Destroyer of games.
Oh, ultimate.
Witch Doctor, here we go.
No, why are you targeting?
Gotta get Sedoy. Sedoy gets Graves. Secure, got him.
The you got him right there.
This is like more of victory time. Like, yeah, you just can't get anything done.
And the kill. He's gonna get silence. He's silenced. He's dead. Now you get Jotun.
I just want to see the team fight recap. I just want to see the team fight recap. Here we go.
Wait for it. Wait for it.
All right, team fight recap.
Damn, that's another 5K.
That's like almost 6K.
That is so funny. Not that it matters anymore, but hey. Yeah. It's nice to see. Now against Mega Creep.
Actually, Silencer has a full Aghanim's finish.
Yes. Which helps how against Mega?
I mean, they have a Vlads on Void. Like, they're getting all the correct items. This is not them completely giving up. If you're going to give up, you already have GG out the game, right?
Yes.
They haven't GG yet against Mega Creeps.
They haven't GG'd against Mega Creeps, which
is
I understand.
Is it because, like, you're doing more of victory, or do you think they're seriously thinking about this game? Because let's be real, if you don't think you can win the game, just might as well save everybody some time and GG out.
Well,
you say that, but at the same time,
this is just like moral building. If you get a couple kills here, it actually motivates you as a team. And next time you play, you'll be like, okay, yeah, we got destroyed. But even when we got destroyed, we got something out of the late game. A game that wasn't winnable.
Radiant. I don't know, like, I don't think it's very motivating to defend against Mega Creeps.
Let's say you can defend for 5 minutes against Mega Creeps, okay. 20 minutes into the game.
Right.
That says something about you.
No, it just says you're cleaving hard, I guess. I don't know what it says about you. It doesn't say anything about your character. DK Phobos is dying. Okay, he just died to Mega Creeps.
Zero is dying? Zero is dying.
Yeah, their base is dying too.
Details.
Alright, big okay, RP,
take
skewer,
him back.
Skewer, where's the skewer? And no, he doesn't have it on cooldown. They're gonna grave him and BZZ's gonna just kill everything.
All right. Just hit the damn building already.
Alright. Okay.
Oh, the thunder.
Thanks for the help. And thanks for the game. GG.
No, that was a GG.
Well, that was interesting at least.
Yeah, that was interesting. Unexpected from the draft.
Yeah.
But it came out very, very well for VP. Carried by the hand of a very interesting G that was 7-0 and then went 2-3.
Standard.
But still getting a lot. And also Terrorblade being exactly like the BZZ Terrorblade that we saw yesterday.
Yep.
So consistent play from Virtus Pro this time. And the final scoreboard is going to be 2-1 to VP Polar. Which means the final standings for today are Empire has 6 points. With 3 games to play, they're going to play tomorrow against Virtus Pro Classic. Virtus Pro Polar with 5 points, they're going to play tomorrow against...
You have it in front of me.
No, I don't.
Oh, okay.
Virtus Pro Polar is playing tomorrow against NextKZ.
Okay.
And that is a game that we're going to cast.
Great.
And Virtus Pro Classic, which is playing against Empire tomorrow, is 4 points. xGame.kz. He's gonna play against Virtus Pro Polar and has 0 points. What does this mean? xGame.kz is out.
Yeah.
And top three are actually six Empire, Virtus Pro Polar, and VP.
Yeah.
Each one of them can actually advance to phase two.
Yeah, maybe we could talk about this more in the end show that's coming up soon.
Yep.
Which I'm sure I'll be hosting. And then you guys gonna wrap things up and be like, Lumi, wrap things up.
Naturally, that's what
so
we do.
So to wrap up this segment, we're gonna run a quick commercial and we'll be back with the end show.
Welcome back to the ASUS ROG Dreamleague.
Nice enunciation.
Thank you. And we're season two, by the way. This is the panel. This is the endgame show. We had a pretty long day.
You had a pretty long day. I think they haven't.
Yes.
What happened with your games, guys?
Well, game number one was, I think, a little bit of an outdraft, if I had to say, more than anything else. I really didn't feel like xGame had much they could do with their particular team composition. And then the next two games were combined 25 minutes.
Yeah, they got dumped on really bad.
Was that Empire playing great or xGame.kz?
Like, I don't know, man. They look like rabbit in headlights. They turn up to their lanes and then they just feel almost scared to push the heroes to any kind of limits in the little engagements. Mm-hmm. And they just, you know, it was painful to watch. It was like, I haven't seen in a Dream League such a difference between two teams playing each other before. And, you know, it's like, I don't want to feel bad, so feel bad towards KZ, because it's great that they're in the Dream League and they certainly can improve off this. But it was painful to watch. It really was. It was like, it was more one-sided than, you know, a wrestling match between LD and Winter.
Winter wins, of course.
Yeah, everybody knows that.
Come on. Anyways, on our side,
we have some great games, actually.
We had interesting games. I wouldn't go as far as to say great.
I think they were great
because
in
I think in all the games there was a clear winner.
Yeah.
Except with a little bit of in game two where Virtus Pro was taking it with G going G mode,
and then he went the other side of the G mode, which is dying.
That seems to be the story of this game. Is G gets 5 kills to 7 kills, dies, nothing. Then he feeds, gives a lot of gold because of the comeback mechanic, and Virtus Pro Classic wins the game. Virtus Pro Polar wins the game.
Yep.
That seemed to be the case in game three as well, but in game three, Virtus Pro Classic went for a level one Roche that was kind of unexpected because the only real hero that they had for that was
Tree.
And
I guess the Dazzle was
not Tree.
The Tree Ants actually were spawned at the top, so they almost messed it up.
I think
if you get a level one Roche in any competitive game, you should win.
Yeah.
So it's like one of those things where you just like, after you see it happen, you just like, as a spectator, you expect to see at least entertainment.
Right.
Because there's going to be a lot of aggression and diving because you're so far ahead. That, plus they got the first blood, was just like, okay.
Not only that, they were fighting against a lineup that was very, very focused on getting level 6 on a lot of heroes. They had Silencer, they had Faceless Void, they had Magnus, and they had Witch Doctor. All those heroes need level 6. And they had Lion as well.
Yeah.
Which, like, essentially, they all need level 6. And when you start one level behind, that gets really, really hard. They got dumped on.
Well, yeah, and you're playing against a team with a Terror Blade, so by the time you hit level 6, you don't have a base.
Yes.
I mean, that's just how
that's actually works. What happened.
First blood as well.
Yeah. So, one more thing about the... we were talking about this. Our game was 2-1. Their game was 3-0. People are saying, why is there 3 games in a best of 3? It's not a best of 3. I'm sorry. I feel the need to repeat this because I have voices in my ear that
what
tell
me. What does it mean?
So, what does it mean?
Oh, God. No, this again.
You have to think about this tournament, like this phase, as a 3-match round robin. So everyone plays everyone 3 times. Mm-hmm. It just happens that they play the 3 times the same day
right. To
make it easier. So what you saw was 3 best of 1s and not 1 best of 3s. End of the discussion. We close the deal. Please stop asking. You can keep asking. I'll give the same answer.
I'll ask you again
time.
Tomorrow to make sure,
sure
we all know what it means.
So, Mr. Host, what comes next?
Well, we're going home, but for tomorrow...
uh-huh.
That's not part of the show, us going home. That's the highlight for a lot of people watching. They're like, can't wait until they fuck off.
Yeah.
All right, so what's happening tomorrow in the A stream is Empire versus VP Polar.
Right.
Now, despite Empire doing so well, 6-0 so far, they're not 100% through.
Right.
Because that should be a very exciting. I think Polar is probably the better of the two VP teams.
Yes.
And it should be a very exciting match between...
Wait. You said Polar are playing
I think it's Empire. VP Classic.
It's VP Classic.
VP Classic is playing Empire.
Sorry, I'm just getting
that. Because that was day one.
Mixed
up. Yeah.
I'm sure Scriff told you that and you're in there.
No, Scriff didn't tell me anything.
Nah. All right. Damn. Now, it's going to be VP Classic versus Empire. And yeah, it will. It seems that it will rely on G again.
Yes.
G is a make or break from VP. I don't know. You haven't seen them play yet.
I saw the one game, that was it.
Exactly, because but yeah, essentially you haven't had them in your stream.
G's just always good. Like, the thing is like, G in the laning phase, he's so good.
Yeah.
And he's always able to, like, find those moments where it's like, I can get the kill, and sometimes the person almost seems surprised that it happens. And so G is like, he's kind of uncontrollable in that early phase of laning, you know? And yeah. It's like, afterwards, yeah, you can see sometimes G still has that mentality of, you know, what would you call it, God syndrome, maybe, where he dives a lot and then actually can, you know, have it turned against him. But in the laning phase, he's fantastic to watch. Yeah. He's one of the best.
Yeah, well, we were talking in the stream, B, how this patch highly unfavors him. Because of the fact that he captures so much of the net worth of his team because of how the comeback mechanic works. That means that whenever you kill G, you give your team 4,000 gold. And that is kind of unfortunate because all you have to do as the other team is just like, okay, we'll smoke
target
and you kill
G.
Him.
Yeah.
Target G and you're back into the game. But we'll see if Empire is able to do that. On the other stream, what do we have?
We have xGame.kz versus VP Polar.
Right.
xGame has no points.
xGame has no points. It's out of the competition already.
But it's actually very important for Polar to win as many games as they want because they're fighting for
as they want.
As they can and want.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't want two games today. I'm not too cocky. No, but interestingly enough, they're 5 points. So if VP Classic takes one game from Empire, VP Polar can tie.
Yeah.
And they will still lose because they lose in the head-to-head. But if VP Classic takes two games and they win the three games versus xGame.kz, Virtus Pro Polar can finish first, which I don't know if it actually means anything because they're both top two or advanced.
I'm sure there's going to be a seeding advantage when you're seeding against.
It's the phase two is an A group round robin.
Bruno, what does it mean if they finish first?
I think it means nothing.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, with that excitement out of the way.
Fair enough.
I think we're done.
Are we? Do you want to wrap up, Andy?
Are you ready for the highlight?
We have to. We don't actually
wrap up
right
now. We
don't
go to the standings.
Yes, let's go to the standings.
I don't have the voice in my ear.
That's why we get the bigger studio in here.
I don't have the voice in my ear anymore.
Okay. Oh, okay. Standings.
I guess the medication's working.
I guess we're just saying the standings, but yeah. Empire 6-0.
How can we see that? I want a camera off ourselves for a second.
No. All right, yeah. Well, Empire 6-0, Virtus Pro 4-2, Virtus Pro Polar 2-4. xKZ.
Wait, no, that's incorrect.
They only won.
That is completely
Polar
incorrect.
Won two games.
Oh no, it's fine. It's correct.
It's correct.
It is completely correct. Now I can hear you.
We got told off in our ears.
Jesus, I just.
Wait, I thought VP Polar has more points.
Yeah, already come. Jesus. Okay. Now you saw how far it was.
It would have been way cooler to just have the shot of everyone squinting.
That's
really
what I wanted. That was how
I can
was
see it perfectly fine.
You're also the closest.
You're like 3 meters closer than me.
Yeah. And you also has the best eyes, I imagine. At least better than
you. You know, I could be 3 meters closer than I am now, and I still wouldn't be able to see it.
Yeah. I don't know.
It's not great.
It's not great. And the red-black combination makes it really hard for me as
it's
well.
It's like an Andy Warhol over there.
Mm-hmm. Hope you're not watching this in 480p or less, because otherwise it's going to be hard. What's going to be hard is for wait until tomorrow because you'll miss us. We know that. We'll come back tomorrow, 6:30.
Yeah, sure.
With more Dream League. I hear music in my ear now. That is kind of like the cue music of get the fuck out of there, go home, leave. Final words, James?
You're not going to throw it to me to wrap it up?
My flies are undone. I'm fine. That's all I have.
Well, he's the host. He has to wrap it up, right?
Hmm?
He's the host.
Oh, you're the host. Lumi.
Yeah. To wrap it up, we are done. Good night. And we'll see you tomorrow.
Why don't you just retire?